Hey, YouTube world, we are back. Hope you are having a fantastic day so far. Please download, rate, review, and subscribe on all of the platforms below. So for today, I wanted to talk about the New York Giants and what their future is beginning to shape up to be, because as we know, Daniel Jones, who a lot of people like as the quarterback of the New York Giants, has shown some progress through his first season. And obviously, if you were to look back now at the should you draft Daniel Jones, should you draft Dwayne Haskins conversation, it seems fairly evident even just 1 year in that Daniel Jones was probably the big winner in that situation. Now, that may come back to bite me in a little bit, but for now, we can safely assess that. And I feel like they have a new head coach coming in. I feel like Gettleman is not long for that job. And the situation that they've put themselves in doesn't give them the best chance to succeed right away. And I don't know what the clear path is for the New York Giants to get to whatever the summit is for them, whether it's competing in the NFC East, whether it's finally getting out of the top five in the draft order and putting up a semi-competent season that can be built off of. It's difficult considering Saquon Barkley, the kind of centerpiece of that team, and I guess you could say the face of the franchise at this point. Saquon Barkley is headed towards free agency, and as we know, the running back market doesn't fare well for guys at that position. Saquon right now, just by being the former number two pick, I think is top 10 in salary just with that. And those stepping stones are going to be a difficult process for the New York Giants, considering that, you know, spending money like that isn't necessarily the best way to maintain some level of success. It's usually with being as flexible as possible and trying to build from there with your roster construction. Now, I don't know exactly what the New York Giants are going to be like next year. Maybe they'll be 5-11, maybe they'll be 8-8, or maybe they'll fall even lower in the draft order. Who knows? But the overarching point is still, I don't see a clear path for them to be successful. Obviously, most jobs are tied to the quarterback, especially when you have the quarterback on a rookie deal. But think about a team like Baltimore that was the number one seed in the AFC last year. Baltimore had the rookie quarterback and a running back that's making about the same as Saquon Barkley, but they had built a strong offensive line. They had built a top five defense last year. The Giants don't have either of those, or even close to that at this point. It's the big difference separating them from Baltimore is the total disparity between their offensive attack and the rest of the team that's been put around them. It's quarterback, wide receiver, running back. You could get equal production in terms of yards of offense from those, but the rest of the team is not up to par when it comes to the Giants versus the rest of the teams in football, and I don't know what the path is for them to get that level of success. I know Leonard Williams has been a great piece, and they just franchised him and want to build around that situation. I know that they've built a strong offensive line, highlighted by the number four pick in this year's draft, Andrew Thomas, which some people were confused by that. I was only confused by the decision to go him over Isaiah Simmons. If you go through our channel, we have a reaction to that draft pick in there too. So as the progression continues, again, I don't see the clear path for them to get to a level of competitiveness, which, you know, they've been in the cellar for a while now. And the one thing that football is great at is that they legislate parity really strongly. And, usually teams rotate in and out of the bottom very often, but, it's an array of bad decisions being made by the Giants that are coming back to haunt them. Like drafting a running back with the number two pick in the draft. Like, that's going to sting in the long run. Drafting a quarterback, but then not having the rest of the team already in place, ready to compete. It's just little things like that that end up coming back to bite the Giants. And, you know, some poor decisions made by Gettleman that will ultimately hurt them in the long run, but I don't know exactly what their plan is, and obviously people believe in Daniel Jones, but I don't know if they should be asking the questions about Daniel Jones. They should be asking the questions about the rest of the roster when it comes to the team success. We always point towards the quarterback. The quarterback gets all the credit, and the quarterback gets all the blame when things don't work out. But in that same sense, we still see the quarterback in this case doesn't have the team around him to put up wins. So there's going to be a lot of misguided information when it comes to the New York Giants next year. I don't think they're going to be any kind of competitive, and I don't know what their path is to get there. So it's a fascinating situation, but I think people are asking the wrong questions when it comes to the New York Giants.